Now solve the following using exponents. Now we are going to the problems based on the laws of exponents. So here some problems are given here. 5 power first problem is 5 power minus 2. So first problem 5 power minus 2. So by using the laws of exponents we know that a power minus n is equal to 1 by a power n. So which implies 5 to the power of minus 2 can be written as 1 by 5. So minus n becomes plus n, minus 2 becomes plus 2. That is equal to 1 by 5 square. 5 square means 5 into 5. 5 square means 5 into 5. That is equal to 1 by 25. This is the value of 5 power minus 2. Second problem, 3 power 5. 3 power 5 by 3 power 3 into 3 power minus 6. 3 power minus 6. First we will solve this part. It is in the form of a power n by a power n. A power n by a power n is equal to a power n minus n. A power n by a power n. Bases are same, power should be separate. A power n by a power n is equal to a power n minus n when m is greater than n. Because y is greater than 3, so m minus n will apply here. So we continue here. So 5, 3 to the power of 5, 3 to the power of 5 by 3 to the power of 3 into 3 to the power of minus 3 minus 6. So that can be written as, so a power n by a power n, a power n by a power n is equal to a power n minus n. So this can be written as 3 to the power of 5 minus 3, a power m by a power n is equal to a power m minus n. Keep in the bracket into 3 to the power of minus 6. 3 to the power of minus 6, that is equal to 5 minus 3, 2. 3 power 2 into 3 power minus 6. Now again we use the formula a power m into a power m is equal to a power m plus n. A power m plus n. A power m into a power is equal to a power m plus n. Power should be added here. I will continue here. This part 3 power 2 plus minus 6. That is equal to 3 power 2 plus into minus minus 2 minus 6 minus 4. 2 power minus is equal to. So it is in the form of again a power minus n. When it comes to the denominator, it becomes positive. 3 power 4. So here we applied a power minus n is equal to 1 by a power n. So 1 by 3 power 4 is equal to 3, 4 times. So 1 by 81. Now we get here 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. 3, 4 times you have to multiply. 3, 3 is 9, 9, 3 is 27, 27, 3 is 81. So this value is how much? 1 by 81. 1 by 81. Next, coming to the third problem. That is 4 by 7. 4 by 7 whole to the power of minus 3. So 4 by 7 whole to the power of minus 3. Now here we are applying a by b whole to the power of minus n is equal to r minus n. N or m, any alphabet here. Now minus, here we will do the reciprocal and minus n becomes plus n. B by a whole to the power of m. So just we are changing the reciprocal, that is equal to, we are applying here 4 by 7 becomes 7 by 4 whole to the power of minus 3 becomes plus 3. R you can write as powers are distributed 7 power 3 by 4 power 3. 7 power 3 by 4 power 3. You can give it, or you can find value. 7 into 7 into 7, write the value. 4 power 3 means 4 into 4 into 4, and write the values. So find out the values. So these are the three problems. Again, we continue. Let's coming to the fourth problem. Three problems completed. Fourth one here, 4 to the power of 4. So all we will convert into powers of 4 here. Because here 4 to the power of 4, here 4 to the power of 0. So we convert into powers of 4 here. So it is can be written as 4 power 4 as it is. 16 can be written as 4 square. 16 can be written as 4 square whole to the power of minus 2. Because 4 into 4 is 16 into 4 to the power of 0. So now here applying a power m whole power n is equal to a power m. A power m whole power n is equal to a power m. For this we are applying, that is equal to this one as it is. 4 to the power of 4, and for this we are applying this one, a power m whole power n is equal to a power mn. 4 should be multiplied 2 into minus 2, 2 into minus 2 into 4 to the power of 0. So that is 4 to the power of 4 plus, sorry, into into here 4 to the power of 4 into 4 to the power of 2 into minus 2 minus 4 into 4 to the power of 0. Again, bases are same, power should be added. When bases are same, power should be added. That is a power m into a power m is equal to a power m plus n. If we take one more, a power b, a power m into a power n into a power b, a power m plus n plus b. How many more? You can take continuously, you can take here. Here 3 are there now. We'll apply the 3 terms for the 3 terms also. We'll apply the same thing here. When bases are same, power should be added. So that is equal to 4 to the power of, all power should be added. 4 plus minus 4 plus is for 4 plus minus 4 plus 0. That is equal to 4 to the power of 4 plus into minus minus 4 minus 4 plus 0. 4 minus 4 what is 0? Plus 4 minus 4 gets cancelled. 4 to the power of 0. That is equal to 1. Since a power 0 is equal to 1. 4 power 0 is equal to 1. 4 power 0 is equal to 1 here. So now we go for the next problem. Fifth question. Fifth problem. Minus 2 to the power of, important problem this one. Minus 2 to the power of x plus 1 into minus 2 to the power of 7 is equal to minus 2 to the power of 12. Here we have the equation. The equation in the here is equal to, no, that's why it is the equation. Is equal to left side is called LHS left hand side, and is equal to right side is called the right hand side. So here right hand side the base is minus 2 and left hand side both bases are also minus 2. So here we have left hand side, we have two terms. So we make these two terms into one term. So that here right hand side also one term. So that we can equate the powers here. When bases are equal, powers should be equated. So now here, first we'll apply here a power m into a power m, a power m. Here bases are same, a power m and a power m. When bases are same, power should be added. That is equal to a power m plus n. For LHS we are applying, which implies minus 2 to the power of. When bases are same, power should be added. These both are added. X plus 1 plus 7. So this is m, this is n. That is equal to, remains as is, minus 2 to the power of 12. Minus 2 to the power of 12. So which implies, I will repeat here, a power m into a power n is equal to a power m plus n. A power m plus n. X plus 1 plus 7. This one is as it is. So minus 2. Minus 2 to the power of, here x plus 1 plus 7. 7 plus 1 what? 8. So x plus 8 is equal to minus 2 to the power of 12. So now here bases are equal. So here we are applying a power m is equal to a power n, implies m is equal to n. When bases are equal, power should be equated, which implies when bases are equal, power should be equated. Then what do you get here? Here bases are equal, now powers we have to equate. X plus 8 is equal to 12, which implies x is equal to 12 minus 8. Which implies x is equal to 12 minus 8 is equal to 4. I will repeat once again. It is in the form of a power m into a power n. So that's why a power m into a power n is equal to a power m plus n. When bases are same, power should be added. So x plus 1 plus 7 is added is equal to right hand side as is minus 2 to the power of 12. So x plus 1 plus 7, 7 plus 1 what 8 here? Minus 2 to the power of x plus 8 and right hand side as is minus 2 to the power of 12. So now when bases are same, power should be added. That is a power m. A power m is equal to, a power m is equal to a power n. When bases are equal, power should be added. So when a power m is equal to a power n, bases are equated. Powers are equated here. When bases are equal, powers to be equated. So here a power m is equal to a power n is equal to m is equal to n. So x plus 8 is equal to 12. So because bases are equal, powers to be equated. So minus 2 is same, no? It is neglected and powers are equated. X plus 8 is equal to 12. So transform plus 8 to the right hand side, plus 8 becomes a minus 8. X is equal to 12 minus 8. So x is equal to 12 minus 8 is equal to 4. So these are the 5 problems. Okay, now coming for the 6th problem here. So here there are 3 brackets, square bracket, curly brackets and open brackets or small brackets you can say. So here this is the square bracket, for whole this is the square bracket. And this is the floor bracket. This is floor bracket for these two terms. This square bracket is for 1, 2, 3 terms. And this floor bracket is for 2 terms. So first of all, we have to simplify these two terms. That indicates this is the floor bracket. And this is separately we have to simplify. This small bracket indicates individually we have to simplify. So you should be very careful. First you have to open the smaller brackets. Next to floor brackets. Next to square brackets. Okay. So now first we'll open the small brackets in all. So here that is equal to, so keeping as is floor bracket, square bracket and floor bracket, here 1 by a power minus n. So when it here it becomes, if we do the reciprocal, it becomes positive. 1 by 3 can be written as 3 by 1 whole to the power of minus 3 becomes plus 3 minus. Here also to make it positive we have to do the reciprocal. 1 by 2 becomes 2 by 1 whole to the power minus 3 becomes plus 3. When we do the reciprocal, negative sign becomes positive sign. Here when we do the reciprocal, then negative sign becomes positive sign. So in closing the floor bracket, divided by symbol here. Here also 1 by 5 reciprocal is 5 by 1, minus 2 becomes plus 2, and square bracket here. So we are simplifying this small bracket first. So which implies that is equal to, so 3 by 1 is nothing but 3. Square bracket, floor bracket, 3 by 1 is nothing but 3. 3 to the power of 3 minus 2 by 1 is nothing but 2. 2 to the power of 3. So 1 not necessary. 3 by 1 is nothing but 3. 2 by 1 is nothing but 2. So 3 by 1 is 3. 3 to the power of 3. 2 by 1 is nothing but 2. 2 to the power of 3. So floor bracket divided by 5 by 1. 5 by 1 is nothing but 5. 5 square. So now square bracket. That is equal to. So now 3 cube. Now we'll open this. First we open the small brackets of. Open small brackets are open brackets. So now 3 cube is open. Now we are opening this small bracket. 3 cube 27. 2 cube 8. So minus. So this is the floor bracket. We are simplifying this part. Divided by 5 square is what? 25. So now we simplify this. 27 minus 8, 9. So it is open now. So divided by 25. That is equal to 9 divided by this 9 by 25. So here 3 cube is 27, 2 cube is 48, divided by 5 square is 25. 27 minus 8, 19. So 27 minus 8, 19, divided by 25. So here 19 divided by means what? Divided by 25 or 19 by 25.